With Coventry Blaze on Spectrum Ice, Flames open with a Robert Lakovich steal before attacking with John Dunbar trying to engineer the goal mouth tap-in for Jordan Coney that doesn't quite connect. Dunbar and Coney do hook up on the back bit of a three-way setup with Coney circling the net and bouncing the wraparound off a defender, but it's just beyond the whistle and doesn't stand. The chances keep coming with Jamal Watson springing Ian McNulty, who splits the D and gets in alone, but his effort is wide. Early in the second, Flames put the power play to good use when Jesper Alisari gives to Dunbar, who in turn makes the long cross ice to Coney and a short delay before he fires past CJ Mott for a 1-0 lead. On a close Blaze opportunity, Flames collapse on the net just in time for Brad Ferguson to collect and forward to Levi Cable, who rings one off the bar. On the power play, Luke Ferrer saves a broken play by sweeping to John Curran, who fires from point-blank range. But Kevin Linskog gloves it to close the period, with Flames nursing the one-goal edge. The score doesn't move early in the third when Blaze find the open man on a 3-on-2, but Linskog is square to that one to maintain the lead. A Flames offensive zone malfunction leads to a rare 4-on-1 the other way, and they get the setup they want, but Evan Bloodoff doesn't get enough of a tip to find the net. With even numbers across the blue line, Kyle Locke crosses to stick with the puck carrier, but makes head contact and gets an early shower after a major and a game misconduct. Flames kill the extended power play and go back to work trying to extend the lead and come close on this Dunbar to Owen Griffiths combination that Mott denies. With time ticking away and Blaze using a sixth skater in lieu of a netminder, Linskog has to be sharp on the original Bloodoff chance and then on the ensuing scramble. After 2+ minutes of nearly constant Blaze pressure and several Linskog saves to preserve the shutout, Lakovich punches the release valve when he escapes to mid-ice before popping the puck into the gaping cage to seal up the 2-0 Cup win.